started at point guard as a freshman last year. So there's some good young guards on the floor here. But again, it's Winamac has those questions, and when you're playing a team that's playing their third game and it's your first, I can understand how Coach Johnson feels. These first couple minutes are probably going to be pretty anxious.
It'll be McKee and Kennedy to jump center, and Winamac wins the jump. And quickly, Dotlich, right side to Gerlich. His three on the way is no good. And the rebound goes to Abbott, who gives to Streeton. Rochester runs to our left to Kennedy, high on the left side. One bounce back to Streeton. And he'll set up the offense against the man-to-man defense. Abbott high on the right side to a cutting Kennedy. At the three-point line. Now high back high on the right side to Abbott. Gives the screen between the circles. Streeton works against Koenig. Now to Garrick on the left wing. Garrick, a couple of dribbles. Now to Holland. Right side to Streeton. Carter holds and studies. Looking for a cutting Kennedy. Can't find him on the baseline. Now to Abbott, top of the key. Left side to Garrick. Make that to Holland. His three is way off the mark. And the rebound to Dotlich, and he runs. Dotlich, outside left, switches directions in the middle over the pass to, or over the defense to Gerning. Now to Schultz to Gerning, left side to Dotlich. Dotlich fakes the pass, who's up for a shot, a lot of contact, offensive rebound to Winamac, out to Gerning for three, no good, long rebound to Garrick. Rochester, the basketball going to our left. Holland across the timeline left, now inside the arc, kicks it back outside to Garrick, who spots up from the free throw line, his shot no good, and the rebound to Winamac. Frantic pace here to start.
Yeah, and I would think that favored the Zebras. They may have their basketball legs underneath them a little bit. Zebras might try to push tempo more tonight than they have in the previous two games.
Here comes a little half-court trap by the Zebra defense. Gernick with the basketball, a couple of dribbles over the top to Schultz. Schultz drives to Dotlich. And we're going to have a foul on Rochester on the reach-in. It'll be out of bounds to Winamac baseline right.
Foul's going to be on Alex Holland.
Yeah,
of course.
That thing in the game.
I was going to say that's a big first foul because certainly things went south when he left the floor Friday night at Plymouth.
Dotlich looks to get it in. Still looking to get it in. Over the defense to Gernick. Right side of Dotlich. Behind the arc on the right baseline to McKee. McKee over the double team to Schultz. Schultz from the baseline then throws it out of bounds.
You know, the Zebras playing 2-3 zone, not necessarily trapping, extending it. So unlike some of these other teams where they may try to pack it in and defend a strong post player, here I think they're playing zone, but they're playing zone so they can keep track of the shooters and extend it more than pack it in.
I'll tell you what, Adam Gernick has fired two or three already from the arc, behind the arc. These kids aren't afraid to put the ball up in the air, that's for sure. No score here at Rochester. 2 minutes gone in the first quarter. Abbott drives, runs over the defense, kicks it out to Garrick for three. Top of the key is no good. Offensive rebound to Abbott. His putback is good and a foul.
Number four, Brett Abbott.
Brett Abbott, just athletically, outman Dotlich. Got the rebound and the hoop and the harm, and he'll go to the line for one.
Zebra's probably enjoying a lot more space when you don't have a Jakota Anderson or Mac Mercer inside the paint. It probably feels like they've got a lot more room in
exactly.
There.
Exactly. So Brett Abbott to the line for one. The sophomore eyes the first one and lets it fly. It's no good. And the rebound to McKee, who gives to Dotlich. Dotlich on the right side of the floor directs traffic. Now works to the left side of the left hand. Out to Gernick. Out of Dotlich. Dotlich near the timeline, works against Rochester's man-to-man defense and Brett Abbott. Dotlich hesitates, now accelerates to the baseline. Outside to Bentle. Back to Dotlich. Between the double team to Bentle. Fakes a shot, turnaround jumper on the block, as good as it rattles home. We're tied at two.
Nice patient move, that turnaround jumper.
.525 to play. First quarter, we're tied at two here at Rochester. The Zebras with the basketball going to our left. Abbott to Holland at the volleyball line, left side of the floor. Fakes to the right, now passes to right, high on the right side to Garrick. Now to Streeton. Streeton against the man-to-man defense. Couple of dribbles to Abbott, high on the right side. 5 minutes to play, first quarter, 2-2 here at Rochester. Kennedy's turnaround jumper at the free throw line is nothing but net. Good-looking shot by the big man. Rochester up 4-2.
That's a nice sign for the Zebras again to get him to stretch the defense and open up the floor for everybody else.
Rochester still on that man-to-man defense. Bentle at the three-point line to Grinick, and he travels, and Rochester going to get it back.
You know, they haven't had a whole lot of days to work on it, but you can already tell Coach Reinhold tweaked the offense a little bit. He was concerned too much dribbling and not really getting anywhere with it the other night against Plymouth. A lot more passing, cutting, and spreading the floor, and I think a much more efficient Zebra offense thus far.
Would you like to see Carter Screeton shoot a little more?
Within the rhythm and the offense, it's just like everybody else. You know, I think he's more of setting everybody up, which is okay. You don't necessarily need five shooters on the floor, but there certainly he needs to be a threat so teams can't just play off him and guard somebody else.
Dotlin foul on the shot, and he'll go to the line to shoot two.
Foul's going to be on Abbott, his first, Zebra's second.
Well, I'm impressed already. Derek Dotlin, he's been playing a lot of basketball.
Yeah, he looks smooth. He's already made some veteran plays, and game does not seem too big for him. And, that's always a big thing when you're a young player getting first extended varsity minutes.
The young sophomore shoots left-handed, misses the first one. We'll have one more in the game for the first time is Parker Fox. And also into the game is Dalton Button.
Number 22, Parker Fox.
McKee comes out. Also, I believe Grinnick comes out as well. Second free throw by Dotledge is good. It's 4-3 Rochester with 4:20 to play in the first quarter. Parker Fox guarding Streeton tightly around the defense, and Fox picks up his first foul of the game.
Parker Fox, though he did not start, one of Widemac's better players from last year, and came right into the game and tried to pick up a little full court pressure and got called on the hand check.
4:18 to play first quarter, 4-3 Rochester. Abbott gets it into Garrick. Works against Dotlitz in the backcourt, crosses the timeline, works left. And now in the paint, stops, rises up, shot's good.
Number 24,
6-3, Rochester. Fox has it, left side of the floor. Now outside to Schultz, to Dotlitz, fakes right, goes left, out to Fox, make that Schultz, now Fox. Down low to Bentle. Bentle backs his way in, loses the handle, goes out of bounds. Going to say last touch by Alec Holland, and it'll stay with Widemac baseline right.
Alec Holland trying to take a charge, which is risky.
Especially with one foul already.
That's what I mean. Ref did not see it that way.
Button at the elbow. Gives to Fox. Fox around the pick. Now inside the arc, where's left side, and Luke Kennedy just is called for a reach-in foul. It'll be baseline left for the Widemac Warriors underneath their own basket.
Speaking of risky fouls, you got your big center trying to take it away from the point guard. Luke's got to play smart here. Got that first one, can't get that second one.
Parker Fox gets it in the corner to Dotledge. Dotledge high on the left side, now back in the baseline corner to Parker. Drives the baseline against Kennedy. Leaner off the glass, good. And the lead is one for Rochester with 3.5 to play in the first quarter at 6-5. Screen through the center circle against Parker Fox in the man-to-man defense. Now to Abbott on the left wing. Abbott holds top of the key to Garrick between the circles. Now drives right in the paint. He'll throw up a shot. Before the shot, he'll be fouled. I believe it's before the shot. We'll wait and see. Nope. Looks like Alec Garrick is going to walk to the free throw line. I beg your pardon. It is going to be out of bounds. It'll be before the shot. Dotledge comes out of the game.
Second foul.
Wow. Comes out of the game. JT Garnett in the game. And also Jeff Nyes in the game for Winnemag. Streeton has the ball in the corner. Now Holland, top of the key, back to Streeton behind the arc, right side. 3:15 to play, first quarter, 6-5 Rochester. Now against the double team, Holland has it. Loses the basketball. Bentle picks it up, runs for Winnemag to our right. Bentle outside to Nyes. Nyes and has his pass stolen by Kennedy. Luke Holds now gives to Garrick. Quickly ahead to Holland for three, left wing. Off the glass and good.
Banks open late, Rochester tonight.
9-5. Bentle gets the feed down low. Now JT Garnett drives, gives out to Nyes. Back to Garnett, left side. He'll fire his own three, left side, way off the mark. Kennedy grabs a rebound before it goes out of bounds. And we'll bring it up against Button. Kennedy now to Garrick. 2:35 to play in the first quarter. 9-5 Rochester. Screeton on the wing and left side. Drives in the paint against Garnett. And JT Garnett gives him a body check, and it'll be out of bounds to Rochester. With 2:29 to play in the first quarter, with Rochester up by four.
And it's going to be his
number three,
third. Garnett's second. Garnett's first. Team's fourth.
Colin McGee back into the game. Bentle to sit for the Widemac Warriors. 9-5 Rochester. Beavers with the basketball, baseline left. Streeton looks to get it in. Does so to Abbott at the free throw line. Stops, rises up, layup, no good. And the rebound to Nyes. Jeff Nyes now runs to our right, leaps ahead to Fox. Parker Fox, leaner over Kennedy, no good, a lot of contact. And Kennedy just rips the ball away from Button and gives out to Garrick. I think I heard the slap from here.
Yeah, I think Fox was maybe out of control trying to draw that second foul on Kennedy. Got a little out of control and missed the shot.
checking in with the Zebras.
And about that quickly, Alec Holland travels. And in the game for the first time for the Rochester Zebras, Taylor Medina, a 6-foot junior, and also Brandon Camp, a 5'8 senior for the Zebras. Streeton and Abbott to sit. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. Alec Gehrig steals the basketball, and now McKee has it. Back to Nyes. Nyes for Winamac. Gives to JT Garnett, who drives in the middle of the floor between his legs. Dribble back to Nyes. They look past to McKee. Ball loose. Gehrig gets it in the corner. And now I believe Colin McKee going to pick up the foul. And all of a sudden, Rochester free throw or making a foul or two away from shooting the rest of the half.
Yeah, it's going to be Winamac's 15th foul. You can see a little bit of maybe the football speed versus the basketball speed. Winamac just bodied him up just a little bit too aggressive. I think they forgot they don't have the shoulder pads on. And it's going to take a little bit. You know, as like Coach Johnson said, only 7 practices. It's going to take a little bit to knock the transition from football shape to basketball shape.
Minute 35 to play, first quarter, Rochester by 4. Kennedy out to Holland. Alec, 3 in the face of Fox is no good. And long rebound to Camp. Stays from going out of bounds. Ball still loose. JT Garnett for Winamac has it. Now gives to Nyes. Nyes pushes up the floor left side to Fox. Now back to Nyes at the free throw line. And his pass is kicked away by Taylor Medina. He's done that probably all fall, didn't he?
Yeah, I think he is the goalie on the soccer team. But you got to still have good feet as well. And Medina certainly showed that. Nice save down here by Camp as well. Good hustle. Zebras just a little bit quicker to the ball, but there wasn't anybody else in a white shirt nearby where he could pass that off to.
Adam Grunem back in the game for Winamac, and McKee to sit. Grunem will trigger it in, baseline left. 1:18 to play in the first quarter, 4-point lead for the Zebras. Button gives to Fox. Fox to Grunem. Looks at a 3, nice recovery that time by Gehrig to get into his face. Got a Nyes. Nyes in the lane. Kicks it out to Grunig for 3. Left side. Off the block of the iron. No good. And the rebound to Holland. Rochester runs to our left. Up by 4. Holland in the paint. Rises up over Fox. Jumper's no good. And the rebound comes down to JT Garnett, who gives to Grunig. And he runs middle of the floor. Things are near side to Nyes. Under 50 seconds of play in the first quarter. 9-5 Rochester. Fox in the lane. Loses his footing. Gives it to Button. Button backs his way in. Throws up a shot. It's good enough. We're going to have a travel before the foul. Travel before the foul. So Rochester going to get back on their turnover. Good idea. Just needs to put that on the floor one time.
It was. I mean, he had Kennedy on his hip. It was a good-looking move, but he shuffled those feet to get his balance, and that caused him to travel. Getting pretty physical out here as well, too. You can see the rivalry heating up a little bit. Both teams going at it. A little extra gear here now that they're getting warmed up.
35 seconds play, first quarter. Rochester up 9-5. Gehrig gives to Medina against Fox. Couple of dribbles to his right, goes back left, and out to Gehrig. 30 seconds in the first quarter, and JT Garnett has picked up, I believe, foul number 2. And it'll be out of bounds to Rochester with 28.2 to play in the first quarter, 9-5 lead.
Good news for Rochester the rest of the way this half. They're shooting free throws.
Yeah.
And the Zebras haven't been there a lot, but they've shown themselves to be about a 79% free throw shooting team thus far, 2 games in.
Streeton against Cruden in the man-to-man defense. 20 seconds to play first quarter. Now high on the left side to Gehrig. He holds the basketball with 15. Drives to his right. Now inside the 3-point line, out to Camp with 12. Camp in the paint. Rises up. Throws a shot at the glass. Too hard. No good. And the ball to Fox. Rebound to Fox with 5. Fox around the defense. Turns it over to Kennedy. Kennedy with 1. 3-pointer at the buzzer on the way. No good. Off the front of the rim. After 1, Rochester leads 9-5. You're listening to Zebra and Warrior Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
You guys ready for the game? All right. Well, management told me they weren't paying me for pep talks, so I'm going to stop now.
You know that place between saving money and sacrificing quality?
We are so there.
What's the point of saving money if you get lousy results? Especially when it comes to car insurance. State Farm can give you the right amount of coverage, plus with discounts up to 40%. You'll like how much you can save. State Farm is there.
That's Jeff Klinkhammer at 223-3017. State Farm Bank.
Discounts may vary 5 to 40% state to state.
Yeah! Zebra Basketball. WROI.
Back at Rochester High School, we go to the second quarter. The Zebras leading 9-5. And Tony, you and I just talking a little bit off the air there that Coach Johnson for Winamac already using every one of his varsity players. And I mean varsity, I don't mean the kids that play some JV is up on the varsity bench tonight, but all the varsity players.
Yeah, that's byproduct of, you know, first game of the season for Winamac, not knowing what you got. You got the football legs still in you, trying to find some combinations of work, keep everybody fresh. He probably knows that Rochester wants to push tempo, which they are, and you want to make sure you keep everybody fresh and be ready for the full 32. Rochester has done some nice subbing as well. I'll tell you what, their offense looks a lot a lot more efficient and a lot more free-flowing, a lot more space, a lot more cutting and moving than the first two games. So good job by Zebra coaching staff getting that kind of straightened out.
So we go to the second quarter. Rochester will start with the basketball. Bennett make that Abbott back in the game. Camp still in the game. High on the left side. Gives to Streeton, top of the key. Streeton, one dribble to his right. Picks up the basketball and out of Kennedy. Luke against Button. Pulls up from the free throw line. Is no good. And Nyes with the rebound. Now back to Schultz. Back to Nyes. Now to Schultz in the right corner against the defense. The Button outside to Grunig. 4-3, left side, in and out, no good. Bentle with the rebound. The putback is good. 9-7, Rochester. Talking about moving without the basketball. Jeremy Bentle did that there. It was a nice job by the young man. 9-7, Rochester. A minute gone in the second quarter. The Zebras of the basketball going to our left. Now we're going to have an illegal screen. And the way Medina looks, it'll be on him.
Yep, that's going to be Medina's first. Rochester's fourth.
Medina checking back in with the Zebras.
So Alec Holland back into the game. Camp to set. Dom Thomas in the game, who had a nice JV game tonight. He's in the game for the first time tonight. And Taylor Medina will sit down. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. 7 minutes to play in the first half. Rochester up 9-7. Schultz. Nice. Back to Schultz at the volleyball line, left side. Now at the three-point line, the corner to Button. His pass over the top of the defense, tipped away and stolen by Holland. And Holland has on the right side. Now in the corner to Abbott. Abbott backs his way in, feeds down low to Dom. Dom over Grunig is no good. And the rebound to Schultz. Schultz runs to our right. He'll go up against Kennedy. Throws up a shot at the glass. It's no good. Kennedy grabs the board. Now to Streeton. Streeton runs to our left, right side of the floor. His leaner in the lane off the window is no good. Too hard. Dominic Thomas fights for the rebound, but we're going to have an over-the-back call on Rochester, and it's going to go back to Whittemack.
Good effort by Dom, but just got to realize that, you know, the maroon jersey's in front of you. It's good to be aggressive, but when he's got you boxed out, better to save the battle to fight another day.
Yeah.
Nice moves down here by Kennedy. Whittemack's trying to go after him, looks like, to get that second foul. Luke's kind of baited him in. Guys think that he's going to make contact, and he's backing off the last minute, which is not only causing him not to get the foul, but also miss the shot. Zebra's back in a 2-3 zone, maybe try to protect Luke a little bit.
6 minutes to play, first half, 9-7 Rochester. Rochester's been actually stuck on that nine for a while. Button to Grunig, three, right wing, no good. Kennedy with the board. He's had a lot of great looks. He can't get anything to fall right now.
About the fifth rebound for Luke already as well.
Kennedy just inside the arc. His jumper's good from about 18 feet away, and Rochester back up by four. Quickly went him back the other way. Grunig fakes a three. Outside to Schultz. He'll go to the basket. His jumper no good. And Abbott with the rebound. Abbott around the defense to Streeton. Rochester runs to our left. Streeton fills the middle of the floor. Now on the right wing. Goes to the baseline. Back to back outside to Kennedy. Just inside the arc. Kennedy shot is good again. Luke Kennedy has four consecutive trip points. Garrett comes back into the game. Streeton to sit. JT Garnett, McKee back in. Also Fox back in. Button, Nyes, and Bentle. Grunig coming out.
Big man's feeling it. Well, that's, you know, when your center can step out and hit the 15 feet and hit in transition and the pull-up jumper, nice dynamic for Luke. And, you know, the Winamax is going to have to start keying on him, which should open up other people as
yeah,
well.
You're right. 5-10 to play, first half. Rochester up 13-7. McKee, left side to Fox. Back door to Bentle. Bentle has it. Now he kicks it to Garnett. He'll fire a three right wing. Short, and Dom Thomas with the rebound. Dom dribbles out of trouble. Spin move gives to Kennedy. Now outside to Gehrig. Rochester runs to our left, up by six. Gehrig hesitates, drives the baseline. Spin move, 15-footer, no good. Gets his own rebound. In the paint, kicks it out to Kennedy. Luke from 15 feet, off the glass and good.
He's getting the big man the ball.
Is that eight?
Yeah.
Garnett, right side. Now to Fox, with the double team. Kicks it out to Bentle from just inside the three-point line. In and out, no good. Ball being tipped around. Out of bounds. They're going to say last touch by McKee. It'll go back to Rochester. And Noah Dahlquist will come in for the first time tonight. Noah is a 6'4 senior for the Rochester Zebras. And Luke Kennedy to set with 4:27 to play first half.
Well-deserved break. Hide him for that second foul. I mean, the guy's got 8 points. He came in averaging 6 points a game, so he's already eclipsed that, but he's right to probably where Coach wants him. He'll take 8 points a half from Luke Kennedy all day long.
Dahlquist down low to Holland on the left baseline. Alec Holland kicks it out to Thomas, and Thomas tied up with Fox, and it's going to go to Winnemack on the offensive turnover.
A little bit of an unusual lineup here for the Zebras. Dom Thomas usually playing inside with Dahlquist on the floor at the same time. He's had to play out a little bit and got tied up by the quicker guard from Winnemack.
I'm not sure we've seen this yet, have we?
No, I don't think you have.
JT Garnett high on the left side for Winnemack. 8-point lead right now for Rochester. Ball loose. Garrick picks up a loose basketball for Rochester. Turnover for Winnemack, and the Zebras coming to our left. Under 4 to play in the first half, up by 8. Holland, awfully quiet in the first half. Gives to Thomas behind the arc. Now to Abbott. Abbott back to Thomas. Jumper from the elbow is short. And the rebound to Winnemack and Schultz. Levi Schultz, middle of the floor. Spin move in the lane. Kicks it in the corner to wide open Fox. He fakes a three. He drives. Cut off by the double team. His pass out a little to McKee. His shot. Good and a foul. Fowler wasn't a foul before McKee got the basketball. Beyond me. But Winnemack made it count when McKee got it. He's hacked in the act, and he'll go to the line to shoot one.
Number three.
Foul's a big one on for Rochester. That's Alec Collins' second foul. And the Zebras six, so both teams are at six fouls, will be shooting free throws the rest of the way. And now I think we've got 20 guys have played in this game. I think both teams have used five guys off the bench already.
Matt Basham just checked in, a 5'10 senior. Shooting will come in, and Alec Holland, like Tony said, probably done for majority of this half, I'm guessing.
Unless you maybe get an end of a quarter situation where you're going to get the last shot, you want him in there for offense. But, you've got a six-point lead. You've got Kennedy and Holland on the bench. This is a big time for these guys to either maintain the lead or extend it a little bit.
Abbott holds the basketball behind the arc on the right wing. Now Basham top of the key, quickly to Garrick left side. Garrick penetrates in the lane, loses a handle. Noah Dahlquist picks it up. He'll fire a 15-footer. Nope. Rebound to Fox. Parker Fox loses the basketball to Garrick. Reverse layup is good. 17-9, Rochester. 3 minutes to play in the first half.
Garrick's pretty efficient. We saw that last week in Plymouth. He scored in every quarter, and he's scored in the first two quarters tonight as well.
Ball loose again. Garrick for Rochester with the basketball, and then he turns it over. Fox has it. He's in the paint. He'll go in for the shot. It's good and a foul. Well, I tell you what, this young man is an athlete. This Parker Fox, a 5'11 junior, you can see why Coach Roth needed him on the field as bad as he did as a quarterback.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, he's very athletic, shifty. He can create his own shot, and he's set up some other opportunities for Winnemack as well.
Rochester takes a 30-second timeout. You're listening to High School Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Your Fulton County REMC is proud to offer the new Faster Exceed satellite internet service. They can now connect customers to their fastest satellite internet service ever with broadband speeds up to 12 megabytes per second. For homeowners with fewer options for internet service or who live in rural areas, there's no better option than Exceed Broadband. Share photos remarkably fast. Enjoy better video chat with less jitter. Send and receive files quickly. Exceptionally fast web browsing and email. Listen to streaming music. If you're ready for a faster internet connection, you're ready for Exceed Broadband. Call 574-223-3156 today to learn more about the amazingly fast Exceed Broadband service offered by your local Fulton County REMC, your Touchstone Energy provider.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
Back at Rochester High School, 2:47 to play in the first half. The free throw by Fox is no good. Dahlquist now to Abbott. Valsa Saris, the sports editor of the Rochester Sentinel, Tony, just gave you a score, and Gary travels before we get to that.
Yeah, it looks like at the end of the first quarter, sorry, it's Triton Boys 25, North Miami Boys 1 at the end of the first quarter. And girls basketball, Wabash 11, Warsaw 3 at the end of the first quarter.
2.5 to play in the first half, 17-11 here, the Rochester Zebras of the basketball. And it looks like a zone defense now for Rochester.
Yep, coach still trying to find, I think, the defense that the Zebras play best and being able to mix and match things, and went to the zone and
forced a turnover.
Yep.
Rochester gets it back up by 6. Streeton behind the arc to Abbott. Abbott holds in the left wing. Now to Basham in the center circle. Swings right side to Garrick. High on the right side. Got a screen at the free throw line. Loses the handle. Picks it up. Back to Alec Garrick, and he'll reset for Rochester with under 2 to play in the first half. Up by 6. Luke Kennedy will come back into the game, as will Dalton Button for Winnemac. Garrick in the corner. Bounce pass top of the key to Abbott. Abbott left side to Streeton. Down the baseline to Garrick. Left baseline. In the lane, throws up a prayer, short, ball being tipped around, Winnemac comes out of there with it. Parker Fox runs to our right. Fox, right side of the floor, pulls up from 10 feet, it's short, and Streeton with the rebound.
I'll tell you what, I feel for both coaches in terms of how this game is being called or not called, and it would be tough for the players as well. The officials haven't quite found a rhythm in terms of, is it going to be tight, is it going to loose?
Minute 10 to play, first half. Rochester up 17 to 11. And Rochester and Garrick holds right near the timeline on the far sideline. Down to 60 seconds, and Coach Reinholt will use another timeout. Is another 30. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Coca-Cola Bottling Company of Plymouth wants you to enjoy your world. And now the basketball, swimming, and wrestling are back. And college and pro football continue. There's plenty to do. So whether it's heading for the gym, holiday open houses, and getting together with friends and family, grab the refreshingly clean taste of Coca-Cola, Diet Coke, Coke Zero, Sprite, and Sprite Zero. Make sure you have plenty of Coca-Cola products on hand, either from the store or the vending machine. Coca-Cola products go great with everything you do. It's the real thing. It's Coca-Cola.
Basketball, WROI.
64 seconds to play in the first half. Rochester up 17 to 11. Rochester has used their second timeout of the game, and it'll be Rochester basketball on the far side. What do you think that message was, Tony?
Well, I think the guys were just kind of out. You know, there's some different lineups now. He's got Kennedy back in the game, but I think it's just kind of be sure what you're looking for at the end of the quarter. It looked like the guys were going to bring it out, and I think Coach still wanted them to try to attack the basket. So it's just making sure everybody's on the same page.
55 seconds to play in the second quarter. This kind of looks like an offense that I've seen before a couple of times out of the Lady Zebras. They dribble to the free throw line and kick it out.
Well, maybe they are going to
burn some time.
Yeah.
Get past to Kennedy. Now high on the right side to Garrick. Garrick, couple of dribbles. Inside the three-point line, out to Abbott. 32 seconds to play, first half. Abbott around the defense at the free throw line, out to Streeton near the volleyball line in the corner. Streeton around the defense. Out to Garrick. Whew, almost too many steps there for Alec Garrick with 22 seconds. First half coming to a close. Rochester up 17 to 11. Now Streeton holds with 16. Streeton dribbles, loses the handle, picks it up in the backcourt. Now with 10, works left side to Kennedy with 8. He loses the handle. Now to Garrick with 6. Garrick, top of the key, drives against JT Barnett. Throws up a shot, foul on the shot with 2.9. He'll go to the line to shoot 2. There should have been a foul on that play well before the shot was taken. The officials letting him play right now.
Garnett, my numbers are right. Third foul, and Winnemac's 7th.
Taylor Medina will come in after the first free throw for probably Luke Kennedy. Alec Garrick in the line to shoot 2 for Rochester. The Zebras up 17 to 11. First one for the senior is good. He'll have one more. Medina back up, and Kennedy to set with 2.9 to play in the first half.
Solid first half for Luke Kennedy. He's got 8 points, and I'd say 5 or 6 rebounds. And Garrick at the line right now getting his second shot. He's got 5 points.
Good for him. Second one for Garrick is good again. 19 to 11. Baseball pass down the court. Is tipped away. Ball still loose. Fox seals it. And at the buzzer, we're going to halftime. Zebras lead at halftime, 19 to 11. You're listening to high school guys basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Zebra basketball, WROI.
Here we go, third quarter, Rochester High School. The Zebras will have the basketball and an 8-point lead. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman on the floor for Rochester. Medina, Abbott, Kennedy, Garrick, and Streeton on the floor for Winnemac. Dotlich, Fox, Bentle, Parker, make that Schultz, and McKee against a double team. Medina dribbles out of trouble and gives to Garrick, left side to Abbott. Rochester now going to our right. Winnemac, Tony comes out in that man-to-man defense.
Yeah, and a little lineup switch. Taylor Medina takes Alec Holland's spot and rewards Coach right away with a hustle play. Keeps a loose ball alive in possession for the Zebras.
Abbott drives in the paint, rises up over Schultz. It's shot no good. And McKee with the rebound and gives to Schultz. Now to Fox. Parker Fox Get past to Bentle in the corner. Over the top to Dotledge. To Fox for three in the left corner on the baseline is no good. And Kennedy, another board.
Luke's got, I'd say unofficially, seven rebounds. I mean, okay. That's a pretty good number. 8 points, so man, big man's on his way for a double-double.
Abbott, right wing pass to Garrett. Top to Medina, stands at the volleyball line, works right against Schultz. Now to Streeton against Parker Fox. Look out. Streeton drives, kicks in the corner to Kennedy. 15-footers, good! Luke Kennedy has 10 and pushes this lead to 10 at 21-11. Levi Schultz to Fox. Back to Schultz, now to Dotledge, who backs it out and will reset for Winnemac against the Rochester 2-3 zone. Dotledge for three, left wing, no good. And the rebound to Schultz, who has it knocked out of his hands, and it'll stay with Winnemac, baseline right.
You know, the other thing with Coach Reinhold going to the zone is with Winnemac not having their basketball legs as the game goes on, you don't get the legs, your shot legs aren't there, so maybe off and short on some of those shots as the game wears on.
We're going to have a foul on the floor before the shot, and that's going to be whistled against
Carter Streeton.
Carter Streeton,
his second, Zebra's first of the half.
Streeton. Come on, White. Watch the ball.
Fox to get it in. Does so to Dotledge.
Yep.
Left side to Schultz. Schultz does has his pocket picked by Garrick. Alec Garrick fouled on the shot. He'll go to the line to shoot two.
That's going to be Parker Fox. That's right. No. 24. Levi Schultz, his first. Winnemac's first of the half. Alec Garrick going to go to the line to shoot two. Garrick's two for two from the line so far. Looking for his seventh and eighth points of the night. And he makes his first one. So the senior does have seven. Looking to extend the lead for the Zebras to 12 with this one.
Nice block out by Bentle.
It was.
Pushed Medina about 5 feet out of bounds to grab that one. Dotledge feeds down low to McKee. McKee shot short. Kennedy with the rebound. That's six tonight for Luke Kennedy.
Oh, you get the official number?
Yes, sir.
That went too far off. I'll keep track now.
Baseline to Medina. Medina wraparound pass stolen by Dotledge. Dotledge runs middle of the floor. 3-on-1 break for Winnemac. Dotledge goes coast to coast. Loses his footing. Throws it out of bounds. It'll go back to Rochester. Man, I like this kid. I like Derek Dotledge.
That was a good, strong move. He was doing the right thing. He just lost his footing off. There's a slick spot on the floor there. Or what, but that was a good, strong move by the young man. Zebras get subs in. Dom Thomas checks in.
He's got a lot of time tonight.
Yeah, a lot of court time between JV and varsity.
5:50 to play in the third. I'm sorry.
Tom's one of those role players. You know, he can play a little inside, outside. Doesn't need to score to be effective. Plays good defense, rebounds.
Garrick for three is no good. And we're going to have a reach-in foul on Alec Garrick on the rebound. And it'll go back to Winnemac. You're right. We saw that in the first half. He spelled Kennedy several times in that first half.
Alec Garrick.
He's on the floor now with Luke with 5:44 to play in the third.
A little bit, kind of a bigger lineup. You got Kennedy, Dom, Garrick, Abbott. But he's got a little bit of a 2-1-2 look of a zone with Streeter playing down instead of the top. So he's got some length with Garrick and Abbott up top.
Dotledge has his pass tipped away right in the hands of Fox. Parker Fox then rips it away from Dominic Thomas. Gives it Dotledge. Cut off by the double team. Now against the triple team. His floater's off the side of the backboard. Kennedy picks it up. Gives to Streeton. Rochester runs to our right. Up by 11. Streeton drives the lane. Cut off at the elbow. Got to get rid of it. Loses it. Into the hands of Dotledge. Dotledge. Bounce pass to Fox. Parker Fox to the basket. Layup is good. 22-13. Streeton comes the other way. Streeton in a hurry. In the paint to Garrick. Right-handed layup is good. 24-13. Winnemac running the other way. Under 5 to play in the third. Winnemac going to my left. Now to Fox. 3 right in the face of Streeton is short. And we're going to have a foul on the Winnemac Warriors, and Rochester going to get it back.
Foul's going to be Colin McGee, his second, team second.
And Dalton Button, the 6'2 senior, will come into the game for the Winnemac Warriors, and McGee will sit down. Also back in for Rochester is Alec Holland and Brett Abbott, the sit. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. 4:45 to play in the third quarter. Rochester up 24-13 on the Winnemac Warriors. Screen through the center circle. Man-to-man defense by Winnemac to Kennedy. And the ball is almost stolen by Parker Fox, but he couldn't save from going out of bounds. It'll stay with Rochester on the far side, right in front of the student body.
Good quick hands by Fox to get the get the loose ball, but his feet went out from underneath him again. He's trying to throw ahead to, I don't think anybody was going to be there, but he at least gives somebody an opportunity to go chase it down. Yeah, if he would have stayed inbound.
JT Garnett back into the game, and Levi Schultz to sit here at Rochester High School.
Mr. Garnett has three fouls. He's going to have to be pretty careful here as he goes in.
4.5 to play in the third. Rochester up by 11 at 24-13. Kennedy gives hands back to Streeton. Streeton around Button, works to the right side, now at the elbow, runs into a wall, now to Garrick, drives the baseline, throws up a shot, it's short, gets the rebound, a putback is no good. Ball being fought for, and Dotledge comes out of there for Winnemac. Warriors running to our left. Dotledge, left side, hesitates, now drives to the baseline, and we're going to have a foul. Is that going to be on Streeton?
Looks like it. If that is, it's going to be his third, team's third. I get the feeling like if you're underneath the basket and if it doesn't draw blood, you ain't going to get a chance of a call. But if you're out front, that's a little bit tighter.
Dotlet's left-handed three is good. First one of the night for Winnemac. And cuts the lead to 8 at 24-16. They've fired a bunch of them, but that's the first one to fall. Streeton gives him the corner to Kennedy. Kennedy jump past the Streeton, top of the key, fakes the three, drives, kicks it outside to Holland. Holland on the right wing, just inside the arc, has his pass or shot blocked. Ball loose, Dominic Thomas picks it up, gives to Streeton. He'll take the 15-footer right baseline, it's in and out, no good, and Button with a rebound. Now quickly to Dotledge. Dotledge runs for the Winnemac Warriors, down by 8, crossover dribble, middle of the floor. Sends left swing to JT Garnett, down low to Button, who loses it off his foot, right in the hands of Streeton. Rochester basketball now. Streeton middle of the floor and a candidate at the volleyball line back outside to Streeton.
Streeton dribbled it and handed off to Kennedy out front near the half court line. Looks like, what do you want me to do with it out here?
I saw him hit a half quarter the other night. Garrick's shot is good from the right side of the floor and pushes this lead back to 10 with 3:10 to play in the third quarter.
Garrick now has 11.
Two guys now in double figures for the Rochester Zebras. Garnett to Button on the baseline against the double team. Leans in, loses the handle. Garrick picks it up. Dominic Thomas hits his head on the floor, and he's up coming the other way. Now we're going to have a loose basketball. Knocked out of bounds by Fox on the far side. And Medina will come in for Dom, I believe, and he'll come out. Abbott and Basham back in. Thomas, Garrick, and Streeton checks out.
The helter-skelter style of play continues. I think in some respects it favors Rochester having that game experience. Winnemac's legs may not be able to last as long as the Zebras just because of that game experience, but I don't think the Zebras are going to shy away from a quick tempo as long as it's good decisions. You don't just want to run up and down the floor and take crazy shots and turn the ball over.
Kennedy gets a great pass down low by Medina from Medina, and he puts it in for two to stretch this lead to 12 at 28-16.
Kennedy's 12th point of the night.
And Kennedy steals it. Left side of the floor. Kennedy goes in, gives off to Holland. He puts it in for a layup. Now he's got away with a huge hack there. No call. Good gracious. Hung on his elbow. Here comes a half-court trap. Nyes gets it across the timeline to JT Garnett. Back to Nyes on the right wing. At the elbow to Fox. Back door to Bendel. His layup is good. Nice hook by Parker Fox. 30-18 Rochester. 2:05 to play in the third. Here comes that Winnemac half-court trap. Bento almost steals it. Holland hits the basketball. Now to Medina just inside the arc. His jumper off the window and good. 32-18 quickly. Winnemac coming the other way. Parker Fox against the double team. Dribbles out of that. Loses the handle. Abbott picks it up. Gives to Holland. Holland right-handed layup is good. 34-18. And Coach Johnson will take a timeout. It's a 60. You're listening to High School Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Take the leap into online bill pay with First Federal Savings Bank. Online bill pay is the easier, faster, and safer way to pay all your bills. Hop into the convenience of paying all your bills from one secure website and gain greater control over both your time and your finances. With First Federal's online bill pay, you get control of being able to change, edit, or stop pending payments. You'll have the convenience of paying anyone who you would normally normally pay by check, and you can manage all of your payments from one location. Log in to your online banking account at www.firstfederalbanking.com and jump in today. First Federal Savings Bank, 301 East 9th Street, Rochester, and 814 North US 35 in Winamac, FDIC insured equal housing lender.
Zebra Basketball. WROI.
1:42 to play in the third quarter. Rochester up 34-18. And Tony, we were just kind of talking there that these officials, they're missing a bunch. Both teams are getting away with a bunch of fouls. You know, and I just made mention, you know, that the game went to three officials because two wasn't enough, and now the game's getting too fast for three.
Well, you know, I think both coaches got to be frustrated. I mean, there's let's be honest, this point, there's blatant fouls being committed and not called, and some of the least contacts being called.
Yeah.
And that's not fair to the players. It's not fair to the coaches on either side because the game is getting out of hand. It's a rivalry game, and certainly nobody wants to get hurt, but guys and coaches have to know where that line is. What are you going to call? Because if you let everything go, then that's when games do get out of hand, and that's when people unfortunately do get hurt. Not that either team's trying to do that, but it's only fair to the kids. They got to know where that boundary's at.
Rochester on defense now. Winamac with the basketball. Drewing it back in the game for Winamac. Parker Fox, cross-court pass to Nyes, who gives to Fox, cutting the lane. Deep dumps down a little Bentle. His jumper's no good, but a foul coming on Rochester. And that's going to send Jeremy Bentle to the line to shoot two shots for the Warriors.
Foul's going to be on Brett Abbott. His second, team's fourth. Bentle's going to the line for the first time. He's got 6 points. Make it seven.
They'll have one more. 1:25 to play in the third quarter. It's 34-19. And Bentle will have one more freebie for the Warriors, looking to cut this lead to 14. Second on the way is good again. 34-20. Rochester's a basketball and a 14-point lead here at Rochester High School. Holland works to the right wing against Fox. Bounce pass top of the key to Basham. Basham holds down to Medina on the left wing. Fakes the pass to Abbott. Drives to the right side to Kennedy. Kennedy in the paint. Rises up. Dump pass down low to Kennedy. Or makes that Medina. He puts it in for two.
Great unselfish play by Luke Kennedy. He had a good shot, and he was unselfish and made a great shot for Taylor Medina. You love to see that.
Under a minute to play in the third. Bentle on the elbow. Out to JT Garnett for three. Good. 36-23. That'll get you back in the game in a hurry. 45 seconds to play in the third. Holland, right side to Medina. Medina against the double team. Dribbles out of that. Over the top to Holland. 35 seconds to play in the third. Rochester up 36-23. Holland against Fox. Takes him to the three-point line. Kicks it out to Medina near the timeline. Medina to the three-point line. Kicks it out to the timeline to Abbott with 24. Brett Abbott will go all the way to the basket. Throws the shot up. Good! And we have a charge. A very late charge call. It wasn't, I believe it was a charge, but it was awfully late.
Yeah, and for some that haven't been called, it's kind of a surprise. There's been more contact that hasn't been called. That's going to be Brett's third, Zebra's fifth.
36-23, time coming to an end here in the third quarter. Garnett has it with 11 to Fox. A lot of contact, no foul. Ahead to Kennedy with 7, behind his back dribble. Down low to Abbott, layup is good. With 3 seconds, with 2 seconds, Jeff Nyes not going to get a shot off, and that'll do it. After the third quarter, the Zebras lead the Winamac Warriors 38-23. You're listening to High School Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Local people making a big difference when it comes to insurance needs. Insurance does not have to be complicated. That's why Smith, Sawyer, and Smith Insurance are your local trusted choice agent. They have access to multiple insurance carriers that offer competitive pricing and individual coverage. Call 574-223-2166 or stop by their downtown location at 124 East 8th Street, Rochester, or visit their website at www.smithsawyerins.com. Smith Sawyer Smith Insurance, protecting individuals and families since 1932.
Cool holiday gifts for the entire family. Now at Endert's True Value Hardware and Rental Center, 1619 Main, Rochester. Choose a bun, 10-cup coffee brewer on sale for just $99.99. The original Ball Brand Redneck 16-ounce wine glass, $8.99 each. The True Value All-Terrain Wagon for the kids, just $49.97. Tonka Toys start at $19.99. You save $20. A 7-foot Rockport tree, lighted and ready to go, just $79.99. DeWalt Power Tools, Sander, Grinder, Drill, just $39.99 and a 1,500-watt infrared heater save 25% at just $179. All these holiday values and so much more at Enyart's True Value, 1619 Main, Rochester. Price is good through Sunday, December 15th.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
We go to the fourth quarter here at Rochester with the Zebras leading the Winnemac Warriors 38-23, and that last series was just ugly.
It was ugly, but it was so beautiful. Dean, I'll tell you what, that's early entry for the highlight tape. The big man, Luke Kennedy, behind his back to avoid the pickpocket Winnemac guard, and then drops a dime bounce pass for a layup at the buzzer. That's one that he's going to want on his highlight reel, that's for sure.
Pass is tipped away, but picked up by Dotlitch. Back to Nyes, high on the right side, now to Dotlitch in the corner to Fox. I beg your pardon, JT Garnett over the top and throws into the backcourt. It's going to be an over the back. And Rochester going to get it back up by 15 at 38-23 here at Rochester.
Good hustle by Camp because, you know, the Winnemac players, they got, you know, let it go out of bounds. Good effort by Camp to chase it down, maybe pick up a cheap steal and a layup if Winnemac's not going to go after it.
Back into the game is Levi Schultz, and checking out is JT Garnett. Garrick, baseline left, looks to get it in. Garrick studies over the top to Medina. Medina with the basketball out to Holland. Now to Garrick. Now Rochester with a 15-point lead. You see him run some time or just foot on the throttle here?
Sense if something's open. Take it.
Kennedy's five-footer no good. Garrick at the rebound. Garrick gets a double team. He's going to be tied up. It should have been. Well, it's going to be a travel on Garrick, but it should have been tied up 5 or 6 seconds before that because Fox had him easily tied up. Whoa, whoa, whoa. What happened here?
He called travel on Winnemac.
On Winnemac?
Yep.
What in the world? Holland for three. Baseline shot. No good. Medina with the rebound. And we're going to have a foul on the reach in by Jeff Nyes, I believe. Winnemac travel?
Winnemac foul number two.
Sometimes there's only one opinion in the gym that matters most. You know, I think you'd learn that time or two.
I saw a lot of things on that play, but I don't think I saw a Winnemac travel.
You've seen a lot of things tonight.
Medina over the top of the defense to Camp in the middle of the floor. To Medina in the paint. Turnaround 10-footer over the defense is short, no good. And the rebound and Nyes.
You know, you got to be impressed with Medina's offensive. I mean, he hasn't made every shot, but just the shots he's looking to take is good. He's got to be a threat on the floor for the Zebras offensively.
Grunig's three is no good. Holland to the rebound. He loses the handle, picks up his dribble, works to the left side. Under 7 minutes to play in the game. Rochester up by 15. Camp around the double team, and he has a stolen by Schultz. Levi Schultz against Holland, throws up the layup, no good, a lot of contact. Rebound by Nyes, his shot no good. Dollins then is going to be fouled by Medina. Camp is extremely fortunate. He didn't get called for an intentional foul as he went for a Levi Schultz's arm. Well, of course, there was no call there.
The foul's going to be Medina's second.
Number
team six. That's the thing about Zebras. You've got to be careful. You have a 13-point lead with a 15-point lead with 6:47 left. You just put Winnemac in the bonus the rest of the way. The last thing you want to do is start fouling them and letting them score with time not running.
6:47 to play in the game. Rochester up 38-23. It'll be Winnemac basketball to bound baseline left. Jeff Nyes will look to trigger it in. Nyes looks over the top of the defense to Grunig. Down the wing, back in the corner to Schultz. To Grunig, top of the key, right side to Nyes. Nyes, left wing pass to Fox for three. No good, hard off the back of the rim. The Zebras and the Warriors sky it for it, and Holland comes down with it after Nyes saves it from going out of bounds, but right into the hands of Alec Holland. 15-point lead for the Zebras with 6:25 to play in the ball game. Holland against Dotlitch in the man-to-man defense. Holland picks up his dribble. Got to get rid of it now. Finally does to Kennedy on the left wing. Back to Streeton now. Streeton with Grunage in his jersey. Now to Kennedy at the volleyball line. Luke around the defense at the elbow. Pull-up jumper on the way is short. He gets his own rebound. The putback. Good. A foul. That's textbook right there, Tony. You tell your kids, shoot it and follow it, shoot it and follow it, and that's exactly what he did there.
Yep, follow your shot, good things will happen. That's going to be Derek Dotlitch, his third, team's fourth. Luke scores. He also gets the rebound, so he's got seven, creeping closer to that double-double as he's already got double figures in scoring.
I think this is what Coach Reinhold has wanted out of Luke for the last 2 years. Free throw, no good. by Kennedy, and Parker Fox with the rebound.
14 points, 7 boards for the big man, and one nice assist at the end of the third quarter.
Yeah. In the corner, to Grunage. Now Nyes is fouled as he tries to get around Abbott, and Brett is going to pick up a blocking foul. It'll be out of, nope, it'll be 1-1 through the Warriors.
Brett's fourth, team seventh. That's the thing with those traps. You want to be aggressive with it, but when the dribbler still, when the ball handler still has a dribble left, you can't body and hip check and get that foul. You got to kind of give some ground when they still have that dribble left. You can be aggressive when they picked up their dribble, but you got to be careful that you don't draw that foul as Brett did and put Winamac to the line.
Bentle back into the game.
Usually don't whistle a guy in when the shooter's got the ball in
his
hand.
Not usually, but well, we've seen a lot of firsts tonight. A lot of uncharacteristic things. Jeff Nyes in the line for 1 of the bonus. 17-point lead for the Zebras at 40-23. Nyes' first one's good. You'll have one more. Again, Jeff Nyes is a 5'8 junior for the Warriors.
Broke in the scoring column for the first time tonight.
5:47 to play in the game. Nyes with one more for the Warriors. Looking to cut this lead to 15. Sets himself. Second one good again. 40-25. Hey, last report, the Heat were leading the Pacers.
Yeah. 47-40 at half.
Is that in Miami?
Indianapolis.
Whoa. That's even more impressive. Down low to Kennedy from Street, and it's good. And now we're going to have an official timeout on Basham for touching the ball, I believe, after the ball went through the basket. Basham knew exactly what he did. Got a warning?
Yeah, delay game warning. The first time, next time that happens, it'd be a team technical.
Garnett back into the game, and Grunig to sit down with 5.5 minutes to play in the game. Rochester at 42-25.
Luke creeping on 20. He's got 16.
Got a good game, you're right. Fox backs his way in the lane. Takes it out to Nyes in the corner to Schultz. Levi to Nyes. Jeff Nyes drives it left. Now to Garnett. Now to Bento on the left baseline to Garnett for three. No good. Kennedy, another board. And the lead gives to Holland.
8 boards to go with the 16 points.
Seriously approaching a double-double. Garrick against Schultz to Basham. Has it stolen away by Fox. And Alec Holland is going to be called for the foul. That's going to send Parker Fox to the line to shoot 1 of the bonus for the Warriors. Under 5 to play in the game. Rochester up 42-25.
That's Alec's third. Winamac's gone to this. It looks like a 2-3 zone, and then it's trapped on the first pass, and then they're just sprinting either the middle man or the weak side guard, flashing to the middle to try to take that next pass when the wing tries to pass it back to the point guard.
Shooting 1-1.
So Parker Fox to the line for Winamac for 1 and the bonus. First one on the way is good. Fox, the 5'11 junior, will have one more for the Warriors.
He's got 7 points tonight.
Second one on the way. No good. Kennedy on their board. There's 9. Baseball pass down court to Holland. Holland on the baseline. Against Schultz. Leaner on the way is no good. And Dotledge with the rebound, and I believe Matt Basham just picked up a foul, which is going to send Derek Dotledge to the line to shoot 2.
I think that's just the 9th.
Okay, 1 of the bonus. 4:49 to play in the basketball game. Rochester leading 42-26.
Derek Dotledge.
Rochester after this one, Tony, 10 days off before North Miami.
Yeah, it's the effect of the Warsaw game being dropped off the schedule. That's the double-double. There you go. 10 boards.
Kennedy just picked up the rebound on the missed free throw by Dotledge. Now to Holland. Fakes the 3. Now steps inside the arc. He'll fire 15-footer, and it goes.
9 points for Holland. So the Zebras on the verge of getting a third in double figures.
Garnett. Right wing. Now to Fox. Top of the key. 2-3 zone for Rochester. Pass down low to Dotledge. Over the top of the defense to Fox. He'll fire a 3 over screen. It's good. Parker Fox is 3 more, and it's 44-29. And Winamac will use a timeout. It's a 60. You're listening to High School Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
As long as the kids keep making the traveling team and the new restaurant across town doesn't deliver, you're going to be driving. So it's a smart choice to join new BP Driver Rewards. You receive an instant 10 cents per gallon reward just for signing up. With every second fill up of quality BP gasoline, you keep earning and saving 5 cents per gallon. Pick up a BP Driver Rewards brochure at your local BP to join now. Up to 20 gallons, terms and conditions apply. See bpdriverrewards.com for details.
Come check out the amazing deals at the Winning Edge in Rochester. You'll find really huge savings this holiday season. They offer in-store specials, and the December special is 30% off all baseball and softball bats and gloves. They have the equipment, backpacks, and duffels for your favorite sport or gift-giving need. They carry major apparel brands including Under Armour, Russell, Adidas, and so many more. So visit their webpage, thewinedge.com, or their Facebook page. Call 574-223-6090. Quality products, unique customizing options, and friendly service from the Winning Edge, Raw Place Drive in Rochester.
To play in the game, Rochester up 44-29, and Tony, you got some scores from around the area.
Yeah, boys games, CMA 25, Valley 14 and a half, Triton 72, North Miami 36, end of the third, and last score we have in girls basketball, Wabash 28, Warsaw 9 and a half.
Of course, that's the Rochester Lady Zebras' next opponent, the Wabash Lady Apaches on Saturday night at Wabash.
If Wabash wins that game, they move to 7-1 on the season.
Who they get beat by?
Culver, when they had everybody there.
Yeah. They're a good team, and they were fully loaded. Ball loose from the floor. We're going to have a tie-up. Rochester going to get keep possession as JT Garnett really applying the pressure to Cam Carter Streeton.
Yeah, Winamac really had no other choice right now but to dial up the pressure, at least in the half court. And Zebras need to space the floor, find the open man. If two people are guarding you, somebody else has got to be open on the floor. Just got to make a good quick pass and find them.
Garrett to get Fox. Garrett lowers the shoulder and catches Fox right in the throat or in the mouth. And Coach Johnson telling the officials about it. Now we're going to have a reach-in foul on Parker Fox.
His second, team fifth. So Winamac has a couple fouls to give before they start shooting, before the Zebras get to the free throw line.
Inbounds pass comes into Garrick. Alec against Parker Fox. Now we're going to have a charge on Alec Garrick, who threw an elbow.
Well, you know, part of that is, to be real honest, the byproduct of how this game has not been called to this point. You let these kids go, and there's a lot of competitors on the floor, and
yeah,
you know, you'd call that stuff early in the game, it never gets to that point.
Fox, left side to Schultz. Schultz against the 2-3 zone that's really getting after it right now. And looks back door to Garnett. They're going to throw it out of bounds, and it'll go back to Rochester.
And, you know, last thing anything any coach wants to see is anybody get hurt at this point of the game. A lot of season left. Just trying to dial it in. But everybody's frustrated on four. It doesn't matter if you're winning or losing this game. Both sidelines, it's just a lot of frustration in the gym. Hopefully cooler heads will prevail, and we can finish this game, and everybody gets out of here healthy and goes on with the rest of their year.
3:35 to play in the game. Rochester up 44-29. Abbott's layup is good. Great pass from Garrick. It's 46-29.
Six for Abbott.
Garnett step back three over the defense. It's too hard off the mark. Streeton with the rebound. Streeton and Fox is tied up, but Parker Fox is going to get called on the reach in.
His third, team six.
46-29 Rochester, 3:21 to play in the ball game, and Coach Kyle Johnson wants another timeout. It'll be a 30. You're listening to High School Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Find great December savings at Smith Farm Store of Rochester and Plymouth, like a 16-pack of Duracell AA batteries for just $8.99 after a $2 instant rebate with your Ace Rewards card. Pick up a Craftsman 193-piece mechanics tool set or a Craftsman 6-drawer tool chest and cabinet, your choice for only $99.99. Still searching for holiday decorations? Smith Farm Stores has 50-count spools of premium Christmas lights for just $6.99. Or 150-count spools for only $17.99. Do Christmas right at the Helpful Place, Smith Farm Stores of Rochester and Plymouth.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
3:21 to play in the game. The Rochester Zebras lead the Winamac Warriors 46-29. And after the Parker Fox foul, it'll be Rochester Basketball underneath the the Winamac basket, needed to go the length of the floor. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. Physical, to say the least, in this ballgame tonight.
Yep. Winamac's going to dial up the pressure here. Full court, man-to-man pressure. Zebras will be shooting free throws from here on out, and Winamac will be shooting two from here on out.
Garrick will look to get it in. Does so to Holland. He'll work against Levi Schultz, who's back in the basketball game for Winamac. Holland behind his back dribble, brings it up the floor with Schultz on his hip. Crosses the timeline, picks up his dribble. Now to Kennedy between the rings on the right wing, right side. Now to Garrick. 3 minutes to play in the game. They're cutting Abbott in the right corner against Dotledge, and Dotledge is going to pick up foul number four, and it's going to send Brett Abbott to the line to shoot one of the bonus for the Zebras.
Garrick Dotledge.
Let's see. Abbott's going to go to the line. Has missed his only attempt so far today. He's got 6 points.
Dalton Button in. That is a big man right there.
Abbott.
Say he was on the football team?
Maybe. I would say, yeah. In fact, they only put four on the line when he was the guard and the tackle.
Okay.
I don't know. He is a big man. Abbott. Free throw, no good. Garrick with the rebound, and he couldn't save him going out of bounds. Medina back into the game, and Abbott to sit.
With the Zebras, number 12, Taylor Medina.
3:02 to play in the game, 46-29 Rochester.
Zebras still looking at a little bit of a half-court pressure, at least a half-court extended zone, perhaps a half-court trap. We'll see once Winamac crosses the floor if it's an actual trap or just an extended zone.
I think it's a zone, isn't extended. Dotledge to Fox to Garnett. Another three left side. Nope. And the rebound to Garrick. Alec Garrick will bring it up the floor. Crosses the timeline against Dotledge. Wide open down low to Medina. His layup is on the way and good. 48-29 Rochester. 2:40 to play in the game.
Six for Medina.
Fox backs his way to the free throw line, and he's going to be fouled on the reach in. That's going to send Parker Fox to the line to shoot two now for the Winamac Warriors.
Zebra foul, number three.
Collins' fourth foul.
Levi Schultz will check in after the first free throw by Fox.
For the Warriors, Parker Fox.
Free throw for Fox is good as it rolls around and falls through. We'll have one more. Brett Abbott back into the game. Medina to sit. And actually, that foul was on Alec Holland. I beg your pardon. Levi Schultz back in the game for Winamac. Second one for Fox is no good. Kennedy another board. And he is tied up with Fox. And Winamac will keep possession.
Kennedy just got his 11th board to go with the 16 points. Parker Fox now has 11 points for the Warriors.
Number one, Adam.
Camp back into the game. Holland to sit.
Number two, Alan.
Grunick back into the game for Winamac, and Levi Schultz will come out. Played about 2 seconds there in that series. Garnett in the corner to Fox. Right wing to Grunick. Got a Dotledge. Corner to Fox. Parker drives to the free throw line. Outside to Grunick for a long three. It's no good. And the ball is safe from going out of bounds, but right into the hands of Streeton. 2:15 to play in the game. Rochester by 18. Streeton against JT Garnett. Now backs it out. Near the volleyball line, near side. A lot of contact. And now there's a foul on JT Garnett. That's going to send Streeton to the line for one in the bonus.
Garnett's fourth. Winamac's eighth.
Number three, JT Garnett.
Streeton going to the line. For the first time tonight. Actually, he's only taken one shot from the field, which is only his third shot in three games. Talked earlier about maybe trying to look to score, and that might come in time, but, you know, his role right now is to be a passer and play some defense, and hopefully he can break in the scoring column here.
First one's good by Screen. He'll have one more, and really, that's what a point guard is supposed to do, yes?
Yeah, I mean, they're kind of sharing the role. I mean, Alec Holland's running the point, some Carter Street running the point. It's kind of a rotating thing, but, you know, as a senior and a guy who's been around a while, you got like to have that kind of steady presence who gets the ball to other people and recognizes the role and willing to do that stuff. I don't think points are all that important to Carter.
Free throw is good. Rochester extends the lead to 20 at 50-30. Parker Fox for threes in and out, no good. And Garrick with the rebound. Alec then is tied up with Button, and it's going to go to Rochester. Garrick had a triple team, and he was tied up. Alec Holland coming back into the game, and Camp to sit. McKee comes back in, and Grunick to sit for Winamac.
Zebras probably in their layups or free throws only offense, I would think, with 2 minutes to go up 20.
Yeah. 2 minutes to play in the game, 50-30. Kennedy gets an inbounds, couple of dribbles. Gives back to Holland. Tough pass to handle. Rochester turns over. Button now. Left side to Fox. Fox has this stolen away by Kennedy, and he steps out of bounds. Ooh. Hand back in. Alec Holland will come out.
Back at the line.
Tony Stasiak. I'm David Musselman. A minute 50 to play in the game. Rochester up 50-30. It'll be Winamac basketball. Baseline right underneath their own basket as Parker Fox will trigger it in. Lobs it into Button. Outside of JT Garnett for a three. Short. Shot's no good. Street hits the deck hard. And grabs the back of his head, and I believe we're going to have an offensive foul on McGee. And Street will walk into the other end and shoot one in the bonus.
Just trying to box each other out. And Mr. McGee just kind of threw Mr. Street down to the ground. Carter's going to go to the line where he made his last two.
At the line,
50-30. Rochester up with a minute 47 to play in the game. And back into the game is Jeff Nyes, McKee to sit. For the first time tonight, Ben Judas, a 5'10 junior, into the game for the first time. And Dotledge will sit. Don't lose hope on these fans, or these kids, Winamac fans. They're going to be all right by the mid to end of the season.
Exactly. This is a team you're not going to want to play once they get all their legs and figure out get all the pieces in the right spot. And you can start with Parker Fox. That's a good starting place. And everybody else will fall in line. And this Winamac team will be pretty good, especially in the Midwest Conference.
Button layup is good. Nice look by Nyes. Good finish by Dalton Button. And it's 50-32 with 90 seconds to play in the game.
Wabash girls 54, Warsaw 27,
wow.
Final.
Wow.
At Warsaw.
Wow. North Miami making a comeback?
No update yet on that one. Mr. Garnett just fouled out. His fifth foul. JT Garnett fouls out with five fouls. He did hit one three-pointer, so he's going to finish with 3 points.
Number two, Brandon Camp.
Camp. And Basham will come back in. Also coming back in is Levi Schultz, who will replace JT Garnett. A minute 19 to play in the game, 50-32. Rochester with the lead and Street back of the line, this time for two freebies. Basham in. Abbott is coming out. He's probably done. Kennedy has had a big night. That's three games in a row. Somebody different has led Rochester in scoring.
That's what you like to see early on in the season, make teams have to guard multiple players. Speaking of North Miami boys, we do have a final. Triton 85, North Miami 47. As Carter hits his first one, he's got three.
Rochester's next opponent is North Miami at their place next Friday night. Second one for Street. Short. Kennedy is the rebound. Kennedy then is fouled by Button on the reach-in. That's going to send Luke to the line for two.
12th rebound of the night for Luke, but this will be his first appearance, second appearance at the free throw line. He's 0 for 1.
18 points.
16, I believe.
Okay. And 11 or 12 rebounds.
16 points, 12 boards at this point.
Luke Kennedy's first was good. Nice touch by the big man. He'll have one more.
This is the way it's going to go. You'd like to see Coach, get the big man in the double-double digits or double-digit range every game and make teams really collapse on him, and that'll open everything for everybody else. 18 points for Luke Kennedy, 12 boards. Outstanding game for the senior, just what the doctor ordered for the Z's.
Parker Fox's shot is good in the paint.
Number 22, Parker Fox.
And Luke's going to inbound it. Basham brings the ball up the floor against a little token pressure. Hands off to Carter Screeton. Seaver's trying to run out this last minute. Doesn't look like Winamac's going to foul. A little bit of token pressure as the clock runs.
50 seconds to play in the game. Rochester up 53-34. Winamac in a 2-3 zone. Garrick just holds.
Yep.
That explains a lot right there.
I think at this point both teams said, hey, we've found a lot about ourselves. Let's keep everybody healthy. Let's keep the clock running. And
Winamac from behind the arc tonight, 3 of 19.
Yeah, there were some good looks. Like I said, as they get into their season rhythm, only 7 practices, according to Coach Johnson, as they get into their rhythm and get their reps in the gym, this is going to be a team that's going to be able to shoot, have solid post play, but I think guards led by Parker Fox will be the contributing factor on this team. Rochester got to like the depth, got to like the way they Luke came in with a big night, but, Garrick had another solid game. Medina was there. Abbott contributed. The Zebras have some solid depth in the scoring column, and that's what they're going to need.
the final. The Rochester Zebras get their first win of the year by defeating the Winnemac Warriors 53-34. Post game coming up next on 92.1 WROI.